In this video, we present our demonstrator for the hierarchical reconfiguration of cognitive radio equipment. This demonstrator has been done in the SCE team, which is part of Central Supélec and IETOR. This demonstrator has been done by Chikwang Wu, Jacques Palicot, Pierre Leray, and Christophe Moi. We use a computer connected to Z-board. This board contains a Zinc FPGA, which is composed of an ARM processor and some FPGA logic. Both are used for signal processing. We implement an OFDM communication between a transmitter and a receiver. The transmitter is implemented in the computer, and the receiver is implemented in the Zinc FPGA. In this FPGA, the fast Fourier transform is done in the logic, whereas the demapping is done in the processor. For the management of our cognitive radio system, we use the hierarchical and distributed cognitive radio architecture management, which is a three-level architecture. At level 3, we have several management units which are linked to the radio operator. We have a first level of abstraction at level 2. At this level, you have several management units which are used to make decisions which concern several radio operators. Finally, at level 1, we have the global manager of the system. Thanks to the cognitive management, we can dynamically adapt the constellation of the signal based on the signal-to-noise ratio of the channel. Moreover, we can use dynamic partial reconfiguration to replace the FFT block based on the bandwidth of the signal and the battery level of the receiver. This is the interface of our demonstration. This interface is composed of several elements. At the top right corner, you can see our management architecture. At the bottom left of the screen, you can see a button for the selection of the signal-to-noise ratio. On the right, you can see the used constellation. This constellation can be a 16 quadrature amplitude modulation or a QPSK. On the right, you can see the used fast Fourier transform. This FFT is chosen based on the battery level of the receiver and on the bandwidth of the received signal. We can first increase the signal-to-noise ratio. When this is down, the constellation changes from QPSK to 16 quad. If we now reduce the signal-to-noise ratio, we go back to the QPSK. Now, we are going to change the FFT. If we reduce the battery level of the receiver, we will use a Radix FFT which consumes less energy. Finally, when the bandwidth of the received signal is changed, this changes the size of the FFT. In this demonstration, we have used the HDCRAM management architecture for the management of a cognitive radio system. We have shown that this architecture can be used for the management of the constellation based on the signal-to-noise ratio and for managing size and the type of the fast Fourier transform based on the bandwidth of the received signal and on the battery level of the receiver.